Thank you. Good morning. Jeffrey Sterling is a whistleblower, and we are here today because the Justice Department and the judicial system in our country have failed him. Jeffrey Sterling did exactly what he was supposed to do when blowing the whistle on a program that he believed constituted waste, fraud, abuse, and illegality, and he paid for it with his freedom. But I believe that the point wasn't just to imprison Jeffrey. Certainly the government did that. The point was to ruin him, utterly ruin him, for the rest of his life. The point was to make him unemployable. The point was to bankrupt him with legal fees far exceeding $1 million, legal fees that he'll never be able to repay. The point was to demonize him in the press. And the point was to frighten any other would-be whistleblowers. You see what we did to Jeffrey Sterling? The same thing is going to happen to you if you open your mouth and expose waste, fraud, abuse, and illegality. So it's up to us to work to help Jeffrey, to free Jeffrey, and to expose what was done with him. I want to talk very briefly about the Eastern District of Virginia, also called the Espionage Court. Jeffrey was and is a resident of St. Louis, Missouri. He did not work in the Eastern District of Virginia. He did not speak to Jim Risen in the Eastern District of Virginia. Even if he had spoken to Jim Risen lives in Maryland and works in Washington, D.C. But the Justice Department decided to charge Jeffrey in the Eastern District of Virginia because no national security defendant, whistleblower or not, ever wins in the Eastern District of Virginia. Juries in the Eastern District would convict a bologna sandwich if the government asked them to. And indeed, we see that happening all the time. So it's up to us to force the White House, through the power of our voices and the power of our signatures, 150,000 Americans believe that Jeffrey Sterling is a whistleblower and has no business being in prison. So it's up to us to go to the White House and to tell the president that we demand freedom for this innocent man, and it's time to bring him home. Thank you very much.